Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sanjeev Yadav, Assistant Professor in Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at Government Women Engineering College, Ajmer. Today we are going to discuss about the television receiver. This television receiver, I have divided into two parts. In the first part, we will discuss about the block diagram, and half of the block diagram will be completed. But in the remaining second section, the complete television receiver will be covered. Before starting, we'll go to a disclaimer. This PPT is used for the teaching purpose and most of the material has been taken from the internet, including pictures. The author does not claim any copyright for this material and no legal action is authorized for the same. Now coming towards the television receiver. As we all know about the television, an analog television receiver for monochrome has to deal with several signal separating actions. In the television, we know that the signal comes from the antenna, and that antenna takes the signal of sound as well as picture, means the audio as well as the video signals, they have been received by the antenna, and it produces the current that are identical in form and to flowing in the transmitter antenna. But the intensity is very low. The vision and sound carriers are received together, and so the intermediate frequency stages need to have a bandwidth enough to take the wideband video and the sound IF together, because we need a good quality of picture as well as a good quality of sound. So we need the intermediate frequency stages so that they can be again regenerated to give us a better picture quality. The television receiver. A monochrome television receiver is divided into this much of sections: antenna section system, tuner section or RF section, common video and sound IF amplifiers and automatic gain control unit, video detector, sound IF amplifier detector and audio amplifier, video amplifier, synchronous pulse separator, vertical deflection section, horizontal deflection section, high voltage power supply, low voltage power supply. This is the block diagram of TV receiver. Here we can say that this is the antenna part. After the antenna part, the tuner section is there. Then the tuner section, common video amplifier and IF amplifier and automatic gain control part is there. Video detector part is there. The sound amplifier, the complete part is there, video amplifier part is there, then the vertical scanning part is there, horizontal scanning part is there, synchronous pulse separator is here, and the low voltage power supply is here, high voltage power supply is here. This way, this is the complete diagram we'll discuss in detail. Antenna system. The basic part of any of the wireless devices, the antenna system. Here in the antenna system, the receiving antenna should be well tuned for good signal strength. Receiving antenna should have the same polarization as the transmitting antenna so that it can receive a particular signals. All TV antennas are mounted in horizontal position for better reception and favorable signal to noise ratio. For channels located in the VHF band, half wavelength means lambda by 2 dipole with reflectors and directors are widely used because of its uniformity. As we have seen in the olden days, we are having the Yagi-Uda antenna, that is a dipole with one reflector and two or more directors. When the signal strength is very low, the booster amplifiers with suitable matching networks are used. In the areas which are very near to the transmitting antenna, where the strength is very, very high, various types of indoor antennas are also frequently employed. As we can say that where the signal strength is very high, we can just use a wire antenna or we can use the aerial antenna. Single dipole antenna is not enough to cover both upper and lower band effectively. To overcome this problem, high and low band dipoles are mounted together and connected to a common transmission line. For channels in VHF band where attenuation is very high, the signals reaching the antenna are weaker. There we are using fan dipole rhombic parabolic reflector are used. A transmission line connects antenna to the receiver input terminal of the RF tuner. Now we come to the tuner section. After the antenna system, as we have seen in the diagram, there's the tuner section or RF section is there. Now we can see that this is the UHF-VHF tuner section. Now we'll go in detail. Tuner section is also known as the RF section or the front end of the complete television system receiver part. It includes VHF and UHF tuners, which covers all the television broadcast channels. In the olden days, you have seen that you are tuning the signals for different channels. At that time, you have seen that the VHF is written, UHF is written, it is scanning the signals, and then where you get the better quality, you stop there. The function of this tuner is to select the desired channel, amplify the selected band of RF frequencies, and reduce these frequencies to those amplified by the IF amplifiers, so that we can get a better picture quality and the better sound quality. The bandwidth of the tuner can pass only the frequencies of each selected channels. The UHF tuner, it consists of a UHF mixer and local oscillator. The VHF-UHF selector switches is an integral part of the VHF channel selector switch. When a VHF channel selector is in UHF position, the UHF oscillator and mixer convert the UHF signal to a lower frequency in the IF range. This IF signal is amplified in the VHF tuner. VHF is very high frequency, UHF is ultra high frequency. The ultra high frequency tuner does not have an RF amplifier because the difficulty is producing low noise, high gain amplification in the UHF range. As we can see, either the UHF antenna, then UHF mixer is there. It is getting the local oscillator and it is going towards the VHF tuner, as we have discussed. Here we can say that the IF range is from 41 to 47 megahertz. Within this range, we have the picture IF carrier, that is video carrier 45.75 megahertz, and the sound IF carrier is the 41.25. The fixed difference between these frequencies is 4.5 megahertz. This will be used as the FM sound IF frequency in later stages of the television receiver. Now we come towards the VHF tuner. The VHF tuner consists of RF amplifier, mixture, and local oscillators. Here we are receiving the signals from the antenna, as we can see that. Then they are going towards the RF amplifier. It increases the strength of the signal from the antenna. Then the gain of the RF amplifier is automatically controlled by the automatic gain control unit. Then from the local oscillators, then it has been mixed with the RF amplifier, the signal which are coming from the, and the, here is the channel selector switch which has used, which is going towards the UHF or VHF, and here we get the IF output. The RF amplifier also acts as a buffer to prevent undesirable coupling of the VHF oscillator signal to the antenna. The RF amplifier must have sufficient bandwidth to accept the both the picture and sound quality as shown in the figure. This is the complete bandwidth, so as is shown, that is from the 60.5 to 61 to 68, and in between that these two frequencies, at the lower frequencies is 62.25 megahertz and the higher frequency 67.75 megahertz, and the total difference on the total is 7 megahertz. Now we come towards the common video and sound IF amplifiers and automatic gain control unit. As in the block diagram, we can say that this part is shown here. Common video and sound amplifiers and the automatic gain control. Just after the tuner, the signal goes towards this one. First, we can go towards the common video and sound IF amplifiers. The monochrome TV receivers, they are having the two or three common IF amplifiers. Both video and sound IF frequency are passed by these amplifiers. They include video IF carrier and its sidebands, as well as the sound IF carrier and its sidebands. The required bandwidth may be obtained by stagger tuning the frequencies of each IF amplifier. It can also be obtained by broadbanding when the two IF stages are used. As is shown in the block diagram TV receiver, the gain of the common IF stages and the tune is controlled by the, as we can see, the gain is controlled by the AGC circuits. The voltage to operate the circuits originates from the output of the video detector. As we can say that the from here it has been going towards the analog to gate just after the video detector. The output of the common IF stages is one of the higher and is fed towards the video detector. Means here the it is going towards the video detector. Then automatic gain control circuits. It is using super heterodyne AM radio, uses the volume control unit to provide automatic adjustment of the output sound volume against variation in RF signal strength. In the receiver part, a similar circuit is used, but it is called automatic gain control. The term automatic volume control is not appropriate for television because both the sound and the picture signals are stabilized against the signal strength changes by the circuit. The AGC circuit, as we have seen in the figure, in a television is more complex than a radio receiver. Because in the radio receiver, we are just going for the audio signal. But in this one, we have to go for the audio signal as well as the video signals. As we can see, this is the AGC system, the complete circuit is there. The strength of the television video signal changes according to the variations in the brightness of the scene is being televised. But the height of the synchronizing pulses depends only on the strength of the RF signal. So television receiver automatic gain control circuits uses the amplitude of the synchronizing pulses rather than the overall video signal to develop a DC control voltage. This control voltage is then applied to the RF and IF amplifiers to reduce their gain when strong signals are received and to increase the gain for weak signals. As we can see that here, the composite visual signal at this coming from here, then it is going towards the AGC and again it is going towards the RF amplifier. And here it is going toward the IF amplifier and here also. Now next is video detector. After here, the signal is going towards the video detector. Here, as we have discussed, this is the video detector part in the complete block diagram. This is the video detector part. Video detector, it is the last common IF amplifier to feed the video detector. The function of this detector is to recover composite video signal and to transform the sound signal to another lower carrier frequency. This is done by rectifying the input signal and filtering the unwanted frequency components. Means we are going to separate the signals. A video detector and sound signal separation circuit with last IF amplifier output is shown in the figure. Here we can see that. Video detector and sound signal separation circuit is there. A diode is used. Here this diode is used, which is suitably polarized to rectify either positive or negative peaks of the signal. The use of a LC filter instead of the usual RC configuration employed in the radio receiver detector. This is to avoid undue attenuation of the video signal while filtering out the carrier components. The video signal shown in figure is the correct polarity for feeding to the cathode or the picture tube after one stage of the video amplification. In the next section, we will study the remaining part of the receiver. Thank you.